And now we come to what a lot of people consider the $64 question, radiation. This is the one new effect obtained by the use of an atomic weapon. Truthfully, it's the least important of the three effects, as far as the soldier on the ground is concerned. Still, radiation affects the body much as an X-ray does. If enough is received, it can be fatal. From an airburst, however, this fatal dose of radiation can be gotten only fairly close to ground zero, with distances practically never exceeding 1 mile. Since buildings are destroyed by blast out to a couple of miles, and burning occurs maybe 3 miles away, you can see the radius of fatal radiation is much less. Radiation from the bomb comes in four forms. First, the alpha particle, or nucleus of the helium gas atom. Then the beta particle, or high-speed electron. Next, the gamma ray, or energetic X-ray. And finally, the neutron. Only the last two, the gamma ray and the neutron, travel far enough to be considered in their effect on the human body. These radiations can be stopped by thick substances. Steel, concrete, and ordinary dirt offer good protection. As a matter of fact, 1 inch of steel, 4 inches of concrete, or 5 inches of dirt will cut out nearly half the radiation you would otherwise receive. Half of this airburst radiation occurs during the first second, the remaining half during the next 89 seconds. So the radiation hazard on the ground is over 90 seconds after the bomb goes off in the air. If you are above ground and get under at the end of 1 second, you can miss half the radiation completely. So, your best available protection from radiation is doing what you do to avoid debris hurtling toward you. You can't feel it, smell it, or taste it. Film badges and dosimeters issued to you enable the radiological safety monitor in your unit to read the amount of your exposure.